a pleasure to introduce our first speaker tonight, Dr. Huda Zoghbi, who will be introducing our science winners. You already know that Huda is a Vilcek Foundation Prize winner, which means she has to be a stellar biomedical scientist, which she is. And she has also been a long-time jury member for the selection of biomedical science winners. And we greatly appreciate her contributions. Huda's life story is really extraordinary. You know, I think I have an interesting life story, but compared to Huda's, mine is very banal. So Huda enrolled, she's a native of Lebanon, and she enrolled in medical school at the American University in Beirut, where she completed the first year of study. And then the civil war erupted in Lebanon, and to keep her safe, her parents sent her to stay with relatives in the United States. And this was supposed to be a very short stay, but the war in Lebanon dragged on, and Huda could not return home to continue her medical studies. Instead, she transferred to Meharry Medical College in Nashville, Tennessee, the only medical school that would accept a transfer student from Beirut. Huda, of course, went on to build a stellar career in medical science, devoting her professional life to the study of disorders of the brain, especially rare inherited neurodevelopmental disorders. I am not going to tell you more about Huda's work because that would take much of the evening, but I am very grateful to her for her willingness to introduce our science prize winners. Huda.
Thank you, Jan, for a very generous introduction. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's truly wonderful to be here tonight to introduce the four scientists being recognized this year, and especially to honor the vision of Jan and Maritza. They established the Vilcek Prizes to raise public awareness of the contributions of immigrants to sciences, arts, and culture of the United States. The foundation was born of their deep appreciation of the opportunities they found here as newcomers. But as I reflect on my own experiences as an immigrant scientist, I think there is a more profound message communicated by these prizes. Each year, they quietly remind us that being an immigrant, a traveler between two or more worlds, is a very special privilege. Whether our path to America was accidental or planned, marked by hardship or paved with irresistible opportunities, moving between cultures provides certain advantages. Immigration can teach us several major qualities that are necessary to succeed in science or any creative pursuit: humility, curiosity, and a tricky but crucial combination of determination and flexibility. One learns to question assumption and embraces different perspectives, particularly in science, which has become so specialized, it helps to be willing to cross boundaries and become a sort of intellectual immigrant to find other perspectives on shared questions. One learns to make connections with new people and new ideas. I believe the immigrant experience that has marked the lives and work of every awardee here tonight is an example of that. For example, Tom Jessell started out a classic pharmacologist as a doctoral student in Cambridge, England. He did beautiful work on neuropeptides, the molecules that transmit signals between brain cells. After coming to Colombia for postdoctoral training, Jerry Fishbeck, who's here tonight, his work came to focus on questions of identity and connection in the context of embryonic nervous system development. Tom has devoted his research to two pursuits: understanding how an embryonic cell knows what kind of neuron to become, and understanding how that developing neuron is able to project its axons along specific pathways to form the appropriate connections with muscle cells. Tom's exquisite work mapping out the neural circuits that enable movement has contributed richly to our understanding of how genes and activity influence the precise location and interconnections of neurons within the brain and spinal cord. His work is now guiding the development of therapies for such devastating disorders such as ALS and spinal cord injuries. Antonio Giraldis, like Tom, started out with an interest in chemistry. But as a graduate student in Spain, he was swept into the world of fly genetics, and from there, ventured into zebrafish and tiny RNAs known as microRNAs. His research centers on embryonic development, particularly a process known as the maternal to zygotic transition. The fertilized egg, called a zygote, initially grows according to instructions from maternal proteins. But at a certain point, the zygote's own genome is turned on and the maternal instructions are erased. This process is analogous to parental to peer transition of human teenagers. Antonio discovered that microRNAs control this transition. He now uses computational tools to study the gene networks controlled by microRNAs in the course of vertebrate development. One interesting consequence of his work is that it helps us understand how cancer cells metastasize. Cancerous cells reenact many processes that are similar to development as they multiply, break off from the original tumor, travel to distant sites, and make their home in new tissues in the body. If Tom's and Antonio's research involves cells that migrate over a long distance, Stavros Lombardas' research centers on interactions that are up close and personal, namely the physical interactions between chromosomes and how they affect olfactory receptor selection. Started this elegant work with Richard Axel at Columbia. He discovered that there are two copies of every chromosome, and in most cases, both copies are expressed. But what happens when one is only supposed to be expressed? Stavros has shown that chromosomes that are meant to be silent in olfactory neurons move to a special area of the nucleus that keeps them hidden from the transcriptional machinery. And when they are needed, they are released again. The idea that chromosomes physically interact and communicate with one another to make decisions about gene expression has become one of the most exciting areas of study in gene regulation. Pardis Sobeti is the only one of our Ford Award winners who immigrated to the States as a child. She was 4 years old when her family fled an oppressive regime in Iran. I'm speculating here, but perhaps having to learn everything anew so soon after having learned it the first time help her to view constant learning simply as a way of life. She established herself early on as an intellectual citizen of multiple realms, simultaneously developing her early love of mathematics and music, along with a determination to make the world a better place. She did a PhD in biological anthropology at Oxford and then an MD at Harvard. She brought together her interest in evolution, genetics, and mathematics by developing a computational algorithm to determine how long ago different genetic variations arose. As far as I know, she hasn't yet found a way to weave her musical interest into her research. But I understand that her alternative rock band has released 4 well-received albums. In a sense, each recipient of the Vilcek Award has built a career out of making connections. Sometimes those connections are physical, as in Tom or Stavros' work. Sometimes they are intellectual. In each case, the greatest progress has been made by bringing multiple perspectives to bear on a particular question, as long as that question has been chosen by one's passionate interest. I cannot help wondering if the experiences of traveling different cultures with all the challenges that entails did not somehow teach us something important about the effort that would be needed to make our way in the world. It is intensive effort to learn a new land. You are changed by the encounter, perhaps in significant ways. You learn that on the whole, the people who disagree with you are the moral and intellectual equals of the people you agree with. You learn that answers to tough questions come from unexpected quarters, and you learn that your own tradition has even greater resources than you expected. It is intensive labor to learn a new land, but immensely worthwhile. As immigrants, we're forced out of our comfort zones, and I think this has a lasting effect on who we are as human beings. And I believe tonight's awardees will have a lasting effect on the world because of the unique perspective they bring to improving our lives. Thank you.